it was important that he has some wisdom that he's on to that that can be pretty epic. So on the poster that I sent out, it said that tonight we talk about irritable bowel syndrome and skin diseases and I don't think we can say curing cancer, but I think we can say might cause it to go into remission. Right? That's FDA approved, right? And curing funguses that grow on your body. A lot of us have parasites and all kinds of stuff in us that we're not even aware of. And so I requested this to talk about human health because I've heard so many of these cures just as like a side story. While Master Cho is talking about, he's saying something about your farm, and then he's like, oh yeah, and it'll cure cancer. And you're like, did you go more into that? And so I'm hoping tonight, that'll be kind of our topic and our coverage, and of course I'm sure it'll get back into farming as well, but the focus basically on the human health aspects of what's going on. So just to let you know kind of what's happening right now, they're delivering your first course, which is a soup and salad. We'll be able to have that. Then between that, between the soup and salad and our main course, we'll have another chance to have another talk and get to know. And then we'll have a dessert, and then we'll have more talking. So it's a three-course meal. This is your first soup and salad to get started. Then we'll have, main entree, and then followed by a dessert tonight. Let's thank Kate Kane for hosting this.
Someone can
trade
and get
that's what I was thinking. Okay, he wants to do it. Okay. Okay, so before we eat and stuff, let's bless our food and get in the mindset of bringing the spirit in. I think Han-Kyu Cho that elected to kind of lead us through that. So he got his apron on, he's in full form.
It's really cool. Everyone bow their heads. Father in heaven, we just want to praise you tonight. Invite your Holy Spirit to come, fill this place. Allow your aloha to bind us all together. Once again, allow us to hear your voice, Master Cho. But I thank you for all the miracles that you have done to bring us to this place in time. Hear and heal. For all of the things that we messed up and you forgave, all the future, Lord, that you have now given us new hope and a new vision of what life can truly be. So we thank you for all the hands that worked so hard to prepare this food, Lord, the love that continues to flow. We are grateful. Allow us to continue. Share your love with your truth so that the world will know the miracle that you started here can touch everyone, Father, from here. Teach us, Lord, to love one another truly as you love us, that the world may know that your aloha dwells here. Bless these people, Father, and all those that here come. Open our minds again to whatever Master Cho has to share with us this evening. Bless whoever will be translating the video on the part as usual. Thank you so much, Lord.
Aloha.
I'm glad to see some of you saw yesterday, and today some of you are. yesterday.
오늘 오늘 식사 참 맛있는 거 하셨죠?
You have a delicious food today.
제가 오늘 이 농장을 생산하는 날 찾아왔습니다.
I went myself to this farm that John and Jackie. John Jackie's farm, I went there. The food that you ate today, and that contains the consciousness of that producer, the John and Jackie.
Thank you.
그래서 여러분들 오늘 음식을 잡수면 그 사람과 이걸 잡수는 게 아니라 좋은 개벌이 가정에 사람을 까지 같이 잡수시는 거예요.
So actually you not only ate this just food salad like that, but you also ate the love of that family.
그러니까 여러분들이 오늘 이 밥값을 좀 비싸게 내고 가셔야 됩니다.
I think you have to pay some lots of tips.
여러분들이 돈을 벌어내는 얘기가 아니라 사람을 여기다 주고 갔으면 좋겠습니다.
I don't mean to you pay the money, but you have to pay some love to them.
Yes.
여러분들 나의 그 인간을 뭘로 지켰다고 생각하십니까?
What do you think you've been kept health for yourself?
영양제입니까? 아니면 가공식품입니까? 아니면 수입식품입니까? 아니면 하와이에서 생산된 영양제입니까?
Four different kinds, is it?
영양제.
So, have you kept healthy with the... Have you kept your health by just some kind of nutrients produced by the, imported food or just Hawaiian, have you kept your food? I mean, the nutrition and food, is it own home, the Hawaiian-made food or just imported outside food? So, what have you maintained your health? You think, is it just the food that any kind of food, or just a specific food that produced or made in the state of Hawaii?
So
I'm repeating, asking you, answer some.
Hawaii kind.
Hawaii made.
네, 근데 하와이에서 생산된 음식을 갖는데 건강을 지켰다고 생각을 했는데 제가 여기서 들으니까 하와이의 식량의 작업자들에게 15% 빼기는 하와이에서 생산되지 않는다고 들었습니다.
So, you said you maintain your health body with a Hawaii-made food, but when I learned after I came here, I heard that only 15% of the food is produced in the state of Hawaii. The rest of them is imported from the mainland.
그렇다면 여러분들의 건강의 85%는 다른 사람의 손에 넘겨준 겁니다.
That means you replace the food producer, not Hawaiian farmers, but the farmers from outside the farm, the Hawaii.
그렇고 여러분들이 행복하다고 하실 수 있습니까?
Do you still think you'd be very happy to have food produced not from the Hawaiian farmers, but outside the farmer?
아닌 걸 알면서도 긍정해주는 건 그걸 인정하는 건 뭡니까?
So you recognize that you depending on the farmers outside of Hawaii, and you recognize that, but you don't do anything to improve or correct that.
저는 처음에 하와이 왔을 때 하와이 주 정부에다 제안한 게 있었습니다. 뭐라고 했냐면 하와이의 경제가 관광객인 와이키키에 춤추는 사람들의 있는 게 아니라 하와이에서 생산된 아주 신지하고 맛있는 음식을 먹고 건강과 챙기는 관광이 그무 이루어지지 않으면 어려울 것이다 라고 말씀을 드린 적이 있습니다.
I remember that I suggested to some of the politicians the Hawaii's tourists should not be concentrated only the hula dance or the, you know, sightseeing, something like that. You should produce the excellent, healthy Hawaii food to feed these tourists. The tourists will be satisfied or happy with this, not just looking at the eye, but also take some of the foods from the Hawaii made.
그렇게 말씀을 드렸더니 아니라고 그래도 관광 산업이 더 중요하다고 말씀하시더라고요. 그런데 제가 생각하기에는 하와이는 땅이 상당히 넓습니다. 근데 놀고 있는 땅이 너무도 많습니다.
But they said, well, we are doing okay with the tourism. So they come and enjoy their sightseeing and looking at a lot of hula dance or something like that. But when I looked at it, you have so much land and very usable land to grow all kinds of food, but these are left alone, not being used.
저는 그것을 보고서 뭘 느꼈냐 그러면 하와이의 어른들이 자식들에게 어떤 유산을 물려줘야
So I was thinking about what the adult generation can give the next generation with something very worth in this whole state of Hawaii. I was thinking about that.
저는 거기서 자식들에게 물려줄 가장 큰 유산은 신앙의 자족이라고 생각했습니다.
The best thing you can inherit your second, third, fourth generation is not just for the, you know, nice view or nice hula dance or something like that, but you can use this best inherit as a self-sufficient food production.
그래서 그 식량 가족적으로 하려면 식량을 생산 농민들이 주인이 되어야 됩니다.
To do so, you have to make the farmers to be the owner or take the ownership of this farming, not a slave of the big corporation.
그런데 현재 보면 하와이 농민들이 본토의 학자들이나 공장이나 비료 공장이나 거기에 하수인대에서 농사를 짓고 있습니다.
But I noticed that all the farmers here in the state of Hawaii are the slaves of this big corporation of the chemical fertilizer company or pesticide company or even scientific people who claim they know everything about the farming. They know what is the best thing to farming. Because they are the making this product of that the corporation can sell you, and you have to depend on the chemical fertilizer, chemical pesticide, things like that.
그렇다면 그 공장이나 과학자들의 하수인이 된 농민들이 생산 농산물을 잡수해서 건강 챙길 수 있다고 생각하십니까?
Then do you think you can maintain good health by eating the food produced by the slaves of this big corporation, big factory, or even the famous the researchers or academicians.
저는 그렇지 않다고 생각합니다.
I don't think so.
왜 그러냐 하면 정성과 사랑과 정열을 쏟아붓는 농산물이 나의 건강에 보탬이 되는 것이지 돈 벌기 위해서 만들어놓은 공장 농산물이 우리 건강을 지킬 수 없습니다.
The food to make us keep healthy our body is not the one that you buy from this in a production of the by the slaves of this factory, big corporation, or big academicians who really teach the wrong food to produce by them.
저는 그런 뜻에서 좋은 개본이 가는 좋은 개본의 집안은 상당히 위대한 집안이고 하와이를 지켜가는 핵심이라고 생각합니다.
In that prospect, John Kevin's farm is a very demonstrable farm, maintaining the health of the Hawaiian people, the health, and he can inherit the generation to come with self-sufficient food the production as well as the good health to continue on.
지금 대개 그 지구상의 농가를 방문해 보면 냄새가 아주 고약한 냄새가 납니다. 그런데 좋은 캐벌이 농대를 가니까 그 냄새가 아주 구수하고 입맛을 띵는 냄새가 났습니다.
When I go around all the world farms, I have very I noticed the very stinky smells all those farms. But when I went to visit John Kevin's farm today, I felt so fragrant, good fragrant farming smells. I noticed that.
그 냄새가 무슨 냄새인가 했더니 그 지역에 있는 미생물의 냄새였습니다.
So I noticed that good fragrance comes from all the microorganisms in his farm.
여러분들 자기 몸에 세포가 몇 개인지 아십니까?
Do you know how many cells in your body? Trillion? 7 trillion. The Drake is very intelligent.
7조. 이게 지식으로 기억한 걸 지금 얘기한 거예요.
So he just mentioned what he memorized by this knowledge.
그런 사람이 농사지으면 뭘 무슨 농산물 나오겠어요?
What kind of product he can produce with using the knowledge of the memory?
지식의 농산물밖에 안 나온다.
Only the farm products of the knowledge.
근데 농산물은 지식의 농산물이 아니라 사랑의 농산물이라고 생각합니다.
But the real good product of the farm is only the product of the love.
근데 우리 몸의 세포는 학자들의 집단 연구 결과에 백조개라고 합니다.
To translate the 100 백조, you know how to calculate 백조? Anyway. It's something like 100 trillion or something like that.
그런데 지금의 의학이나 영양학은 백종의 미적 자기 세포만 가지고 따지고 있습니다. 그런데 백종의 세포를 갖다 위하는 그 부추기고 있는 또 제3의 물질이 있는 것도 깨달았습니다.
So scientists discovered, so we have a lot of cells in our body. But there's some helpers of the cells in our body. Not just the cell itself is existing. There are lots of aids or helper of these cells to survive in our health.
그 숫자가 얼마냐 그러면 그것이 백조입니다.
That is the 100 times of that cells.
그래서 우리 몸은 몇 개의 세포 구성되냐 200조의 세포 구성되었습니다.
So if you add it together, it's maybe 200 trillion or something like that.
그런데 그 미생물을 미생물에 맞는 음식을 먹어야 되는데 미생물에 맞지 않는 내 몸에 대한 음식을 먹기 때문에 그 영향이 약해집니다.
Our health is diminishing or destroying because we are not eating the product of the microorganism health, but we are eating nothing to do with this microorganism we are consuming. That's the reason why our health is going down here.
그런데 여러분들이 여행을 특히 외국 여행을 나갔다 오면 배탈 나는 수가 있죠.
Sometimes if you go to travel and outside the country, then you have a stomach trouble, right? Sometimes you do that.
그런 경험이 있으십니까?
Do you have this kind of experience?
Yeah.
왜 그랬을까요?
Why that happened?
그것은 지금까지 내가 하와이 사람이 하와이의 음식을 먹었기 때문에 하와이의 음식을 소화시키는 미생물이 배 안에 있었는데, 네 안에 있었는데 갑자기 다른 게 들어오니까 감당을 못하는 겁니다. 그러니까 설사하는 겁니다.
The reason why that happened is because you have a Hawaii food adjusted microorganism in your stomach. But when you go outside, you eat the food which is not original, I mean, usually eating in Hawaiian food. That they cannot tolerate or they cannot digest that particular food that you eat outside the country.
그 지역에 내가 건강을 지키려면 그 지역의 미생물을 내가 먹어야 내 몸에 들어와야 건강을 지킨다고 생각합니다.
So if you want to keep good health in here, then you have to consume the microorganism which will digest your food produced by it here. So there's a specific microorganism can handle such a specific kind of food. So if you give a wrong kind of food, they cannot digest, and then it will result in diarrhea or stomach problems.
어떤 말로?
Yeah.
이게 하와이입니다.
This is a Hawaiian product.
이것이 그 대나무 장에 있는 잎입니다.
This is the moldy leaves under the bamboo trees.
근데 그 가장 강력한 미생물은 대나무 숲에 있습니다.
The strongest microorganism usually lives under the bamboo tree.
근데 이 대나무 잎을 먹던 미생물이 전부 다 벌집어는 겁니다.
Now, the microorganism usually eat and live under the bamboo tree. Now, we put this some rice, cooked rice, in the small basket.
여기 있는 미생물들이 아주 수분 밥상에 왔지 않습니까?
This is a special treat for the microorganism here. So they all collect or come together to thrive there. So they all collecting that specific the cooked rice.
근데 밥을 갖다가는 쥐가 와서 먹으러 오거든요.
Sometimes mongoose will come after that.
그래서 이걸 덮어놓는 겁니다.
So we cover this basket.
그렇게 해서 밥을 갖다가는 밥이 이렇게 케이크 모양이 됐습니다.
Now that particular the dry cooked rice, we put it inside the box. After they got several days, that looks like a cake, right? The all whitish cake.
그래서 이것이 미생물의 덩어리입니다.
This is the lung of the microorganism.
이거 갖다 IMO.
We call that IMO number one.
근데 이걸 그냥 입게 되면 힘이 약해지니까 설탕을 집어넣어서 강화시킵니다.
So if you leave it alone, the strength is very weakened. So we put some brown sugar to mix with it so they can be strong microorganisms.
근데 왜 그냥은 미생물은 단 걸 좋아합니다.
The reason why is microorganisms love the sweetness.
그래서 이걸 갖다가 여기다 설탕을 집어넣어서
So we mix with a 1-to-1 ratio of that one, the Brahma Shiva plus Ayama number one, and then we mix together, and then this is a Brahma Shiva to mix it, and that's the mixing, and until you become like this, and then we put it in here, the container.
이렇게 되면 이것을 상온에서 공기 상온 공기에 따로 하면
If you store this final products, ayama number two, we call, which means mixture of ayama number one and the brown sugar, you can keep it several years if you keep on the shaded area with the room temperature.
그런데 이걸 갖다 양이 적으니까 확대해서 해야 됩니다.
So when you use in the farm field. You have to multiply lot more, not just this. This is not enough numbers of the microorganism.
그래서 이제 쌀뼈나 밑줄.
So, to feed that microorganism to grow more numbers, we mix with either rice bran or wheat bran.
그리고 거기다가 이거 갖다 아까 미동을
So we dilute that ayama number two into the water, dilute to 1:1,000, then mix this one with a rice bran or a wheat bran.
그렇게 넣으니까 이렇게 미생물이 아주 번식을 했습니다.
About a week after that, then looks like this is ayama number three, almost like a snow in the mountain, right? This is ayama number three.
그래서 그걸 다 직사광선을 피우고 수분의 증발을 막기 위해서 겹치를 벗긴 겁니다.
So, this, make this, 제가 4번
했나요?
Okay. To protect evaporation of the moisture, and so they cover this rice straw sheet of the rice straw.
근데 하와이는 겹치이 없기 때문에
Since you don't have a rice straw here right now, although you can grow rice here too, but right now if you want to use that kind of cover, then you can use the, you know, the weeds, strong weeds and the alongside the straw, you know? Yeah, the grass, then you just cut it and then put it together and then cover that like that. So material can be replaced with the locally available. So since this one continue evaporate, eventually the moisture content will go down. If you cover this rice bran, rice straw, or you know the plant straw here, then the moisture and then if you have a low moisture content by evaporation, then you can spray some water to put it. I mean, become the normal moisture content. The microorganism is a very jealous one.
사람 같은 건 집주가 나면은 이혼하면 되는데 미생물은 이혼을 못합니다.
The microorganism is very jealous one, and if there's a human being, if you're very jealous, and then sometimes you just divorce it. But the microorganism they never divorce.
그래서 상대방 미생물 죽입니다.
They will just kill opposite. So, to prevent that, you get this farm that you're gonna farm, the field that you're gonna farm, the dirt or soil from your own farm field. Then you mix with the IMO3 with a 1:1 ratio. In other words, IMO3 never had the dirt or the soil there. So you get your own soil in your own field, they mix it together 1-to-1 ratio.
왜냐면 그 박경기는 그 지구 주인인 미생을 살고 있습니다.
Now, the your own field, then they have a own microorganism in your field.
근데 그 미생물을 넣어서 같이 발효를 해가지고 했으면 그 밖에 있는 미생물도 들어있는 겁니다.
So, since you mix your own the soil and the animal number 3, then your own microorganism in your soil is mixed with this animal number 3.
근데 그걸 갖다 4번을 갖다 밖에 넣게 되면 밖에 있는 미생을 싸물라고 된다고 보니까 누가 와 있어요? 자기 친척이 와 있잖아. 3층, 4층이 와 있잖아.
So if you that we call the iron number 4. So in other words, iron number 1 is rice. Iron number 2 is iron number 1 plus sugar. Iron number 3 is iron number 2 plus what? Rice bran or wheat bran. So if you add your own field dirt or soil, that we call iron number 4. Okay, so now you spray this iron number 4 on your field. Then the microorganism on your leftover microorganism in your own field say, hey, this is a foreign guys. This tribe invade me. But when you look at it, there's some cousins of mine. Because you had this already, your own field mixed with this iron number 2 guy, right? Iron number 3 guys. So they said, oh, this is my relatives, not enemy. So they can get him along fine. That's the friendship of this microorganism. So they become very excellent fertile soil. So this is the way you spray iron number 4 in your own field before you plant it, anything. Because of the friendship of this iron number 4 just came in and your own the leftover the soil, look at this. This is all like a snow all over
the place.
This is not by the discovery of the academician or the researchers or anything like that. This is the rule of the nature. This is the
love.
The microorganism the researchers or academicians produce is all calculated the result. So this is the nature. So there's such a the microorganism sold by the thing is but that one is just very expensive. It's factory made. It's not the nature
made.
So because if you want to farm with this microorganism produced by the factory, that's a very expensive. So you cannot use it even if you want to.
그러니까 여러분들이 이 농사 짓는데 잡대를 만든 미생물은 엄마가 자식들과 남편을 위해서 부엌에서 음식 만든 즐거움으로 만든 그 음식이래야 건강을 지켜줍니다.
So you have to use the homemade, the mother produced made kind of the product that the mother makes this food in the kitchen. Kitchen so that you can enjoy that food. So that should be the kind of microorganism when you do the natural farming. So in Korea, if the mother works in the kitchen, then that's a labor.
그걸 노동으로 생각해서 밥으로 밥 맛이 없습니다.
So if you consider the mother works to cook, cook the food, if you consider that as a labor, then your taste of the food is no good.
이걸 갖다가 사랑으로 생각을 해야 음식 맛이 있습니다.
You have to think that is the product of the love, not product of the labor. Then your food will taste better or good.
그래서 계산적인 생산적인 밥하고 사랑으로 지은 밥하고는 다릅니다.
So calculated food produced in the kitchen by the mother, just love-making, love-made food by the mother is a two different kind of value.
여러분은 어떤 음식을 먹고 싶습니까?
Which kind of food you would like to eat? Love, 사랑.
그래서 이 식당의 식사가 사랑의 식사라고 생각합니다.
So I think this food you just ate is a product of the love.
이제 식당에서 이런 걸 보면 젊은 그 딸들이 음식을 만드는데 그 젊은 딸들은 정열과 사랑이 넘치는 사람들입니다.
So I noticed that the daughters of this family is making this nice food. That the, I see this, all the young ladies had this food produced by their passion and love. I'm not advertising this this restaurant.
그 하늘의 행동을 보고 그렇게 느꼈습니다.
I just felt this their action is different from regular restaurant.
Big time.
인우아! 인우아!
그렇게는 이제 하우스 안에 보면 그 전체가 다 해버렸습니다.
So under this greenhouse, you can see that all the snowy all over the place is all snowy looking.
그들은 거기에 지렁이가 생깁니다.
This means that they can automatically invite this earthworm under their soil.
그럼 거기 다 지렁이 공변이 오늘 아주 좋은 땅이 만들어집니다.
These are the product or the root of this earthworm. Then this will make a very fertile soil, very soft fertile soil.
이거는 풀도 나지 못합니다.
If this one happens, no more worry about the weed.
그리고 이렇게 미생물이 덮여있으면 이게 마비 형성이 돼서 풀이 못 나옵니다.
If you have this microorganism layer to cover it, then weeds cannot grow up.
그는 농민들의 노동력도 절약시키고,
they save the labor the cost.
그리고 농작물은 기본적으로 자랄 수 있는 겁니다.
All the crops can thrive very very happily.
그래서 이게 이제 일반 흙입니다.
This is regular soil.
우리 뭔가 도착해서 4번을 찍었더니 이게 붙들려 온 겁니다.
So they added item number 4 in this regular soil, then they swelled up.
우리가 빵을 만들 때 미리 반죽으로 조그맣지만 그걸 붙들리면 이제 커지지 않습니까?
So when you make the dough, you know, when the original dough is like this, but if you have a yeast, what happens? The swells, right? Same principle
happens.
So that means there are lots of space developed under the soil. And that means that air can come in and out.
모든 작물의 뿌리는 산소를 아주 좋아합니다.
All the roots of the plants love that oxygen.
그래서 산소가 많이 들어있기 때문에 땅은 좋아지고 작물은 병이 안 되고 건강한 사람입니다.
Because a lot of air indicated a lot of oxygen is in there, the plants become very healthy, and then you can expect lots of crops.
그런데 이 땅을 다 가는 이유는 학자들이 연구해서 깊이 간 땅에서 뿌리가 깊이 내린다고 얘기하고 있습니다.
But the scientist indicated that, you know, if you want to make a soft soil, you have to till with a machine. That's the idea provided by the scientist, and that that's what the normal farmers think. We gotta till this soil.
근데 기계로 땅을 만들면 20cm 정도 30cm 이렇게 못 갑니다.
So actually, if you want to till with a heavy tractor machine, you can only till about 20 to maximum 30 centimeters, 1 foot, even less than 1 foot. That's the only, yeah? 20 inches?
No, about 25 millimeters.
20 to 25 millimeters.
So, this strength, I mean the height of this particular crops, that same height of the root will develop under the soil.
그럼 깊이 가면 뿌리가 약이 내립니까? 약이 갈려야 뿌리가 깊이 내립니까?
So, what is your answer? If you till with a machine with this much, do you think the root system will go down that deep? You did not use any machine, but this earth form of the microorganism can dig down deep, like this one.
그러면 깊이 한 땅에 뿌리가 약이 되었는데도 불구하고 돈을 비싸게 주면서 수렵게 살 땅을 나는 건 과학 영농이요, 바보 영농이요.
So what do you think? If you spend a lot of money to buy this expensive tractor and till only this much, is that smarter than what let this IMO4 working for you, make a deep, soft soil? Which one makes sense?
IMO4.
So I'll leave up to your judgment. 7 feet metal stick. This is a metal stick of about 2 meters. See, it goes down soft, almost like the cake. Yeah. You know, the soft spongy cake. It's just like that. It just went down because that's all soft area.
이렇게 되면은 그 농기계가 비싼 돈 산 돈이나 그 농기계 사서 땅을 갈기 아니라 미생물을 길러서 땅을 기르는 게 훨씬 지혜롭습니다.
It's wiser idea to use microorganism to make this fertile soil by using microorganism rather than you buy this expensive tractor. With only can till about this much depth.
오늘 그 좋은 캐고리 농장 갔었는데 한국에 숯꽁지를 파는 것 같았습니다.
Yeah, I went to the John Cabrera's farm today. I stepped on my feet on that ground, and almost like a sponge the floor.
그 안에 얼마나 많은 생명체가 살고 있느냐 그런 겁니다.
I can imagine how many lively the organisms are living underneath.
여러분 단단한 땅을 살고 싶습니까? 스포츠 같은 땅을 살고 싶습니까?
Do you like to live on the sponge-like soil on the ground, or do you like the hard like a cement floor? Sponge.
그렇게 생각한다면 실천을 하십시오.
If you think so, just practice.
지금 요거 씨를 심었습니다.
So I just planted small seed.
근데 요 씨는 요것이 자라서 고단성을 영위할 수 있을 만큼 영양으로 가득 나와 있습니다.
So actually, while every seed has a potential to sprout and start growing.
여러분들 그 엄마 젖의 영양가치가 많습니다. 소 젖의 영양가치가 많다고 생각하십니까?
Now, I want to ask you, see, which milk has more nutrients or nutrition for your own baby, mama's milk or cow's milk?
아니에요. 분석으로 보면 소 젖이 영양가치가 많습니다.
If you analyze the cow's milk versus mother's milk, the amount of nutrition is more on the cow side than the mother side.
그래서 엄마 젖은 사랑이 들어 있고 그 소 젖은 영양소가 들어 있습니다.
So the comparison of the mother's milk with the cow's milk is mother's milk has less nutrient, but they have lots of love with it. Versus the cow's milk has no love, but more nutrition.
그런데 그 장사꾼들은 뭐라 그랬냐 그러면 먹고 빨리빨리 크면은 영양가치가 많다고 생각해서 소조소 믿음을 본다는 겁니다.
So the corporation or the factory people emphasize if you give cow's milk, you can grow faster or more. Why? Because you have more nutrition in it.
그래서 한 20년 전까지만 해도 어떤 공장에 나온 그 젖이 아기가 더 크게 자라냐.
So 20 years ago, they always see whether there is any competition of which milk, which cow's milk has make this baby grow more bigger. That was a competition that everybody was interested in.
그래서 그 우유공장에서 젖공장에서 그 등진을 열어가지고 자기 집 젖을 먹은 애들이 크게 자랐다 그리고 몸무게가 많아졌다 그러면 그것이 좋은 젖이라고 해서 상용 좋고 그 젖이 잘 팔렸습니다.
So there was some event once a year or something like that have some competition event which company milk makes this fatter baby and then they awarded this fattest baby for this the milk company's product.
그 몸이 크고 무게가 많이 나가는 것이 애기에게 좋다면 회색인 일이 없고요.
If that's true, the fattest baby is the best one. Why don't you try with this pig to grow pig instead of the baby?
그래서 요즘에 아이들이 몸이 튼튼해지면서 돼지 영양분을 줬기 때문에 몸이 튼튼해지는 겁니다.
So, because nowadays a lot of babies become very chubby or obese, that's because of we gave this wrong nutrition, not proper nutrients for the baby, for the human baby, but it's somebody else like cow's milk, which is not really the one that produced, God, the creator design.
근데 이제 엄마 젖을 먹고 자란 애들은 사랑을 전수해줬기 때문에 약 순합니다.
The mom's milk made the baby very soft and not very angry.
근데 소조선 먹은 소는 성비는 되게 받습니다.
But if the baby fed by this cow's milk, when they get upset or mad, they just hit. Mad and irritated.
그래서 요즘에 아이들이 부모에게 반항하는 겁니다.
Because all these big children nowadays who were grown up with this cow's milk, they resist against their parents, not obedient.
거기다가 아기를 갖다 하나하나 둘밖에 안 낳거든요.
Nowadays they only have one or two babies. That's it.
그러니까 엄마 부모들이 아주 기회를 위해서 믿는 거죠.
So that parents are very overprotected those one or two babies. So we, they want to make sure these two babies are all successful.
그렇게 되면 그 아이들은 부모가 나를 위해서 있는 거지 부모가 나를 낳아줬다는 고마움을 모르는 겁니다.
So these babies nowadays they don't want to grateful or thankful to the parents because they think that mom just think I'm the one of the machine that can support it, but not without I mean not with the love of the born with the mother's the love.
그래서 큰 농사 짓는 걸 보면 농민들 너무 농장으로 과보호하고 있습니다.
Same thing is happening in the farming industry, farming field. That the farmers are overfeed these plants.
그래서 자립용은 없어지고 의존용만 생겨납니다.
So they have a dependency, but no independent the character of the plants.
그게 약해지면 병원이니까 약품을 주는 겁니다.
Because if they weaken due to this dependency, then they get sick very often, and then you have to spray some pesticide.
여러분, 우리가 엄마한테 먹여서 건강을 지키는 것이 과학입니까? 아니면 소주를 먹여가지고 병원인데 약을 주어서 지키는 것이 과학입니까?
So which do you think with of scientific idea to make this baby very weakened immune system and get sick and then you give to the medicine for those baby or you give just mama's milk so that baby can get healthier and don't have to be sick often that you don't have to use any medicine for that.
자, 근데 여기 엄마를 계시면 엄마한테 내줘서 먹일 때 애기가 가만히 빨아먹습니까?
So some of the ladies here is a mother who probably had the experience of the breastfeed the baby. When you feed your breast milk, do they just suck it very gently or just suck it all their the strength?
심을 주고 가면서 심으로 대하면서 술쭉 같이 대하면서 빨아먹지 않습니까?
So if you notice very carefully, when the baby sucks their milk, they don't just suck it very gently. They use all their powers, all their deep expression, deep respiration, so all the strength they use to suck it.
그러면 심호흡을 없고 저절 먹으면 폐 활량이 늘어나는 겁니다.
The lung function, lung volume, will be expanded because they take deep inspiration. Okay? They win the deep inspiration when they suck the
milk.
So because they move their hands and then they just exercise of this skeletal system and muscle system.
기계로 땅을 갈아서 농사 짓는 거고 미생물이 갈아서 농사 짓는 거고 차이점이 그런 거라고 생각합니다.
So it's a similar episode happening in the farming when you have used the microorganism to till versus this the till with this machine. That is a similar things happening in the human the babies.
근데 한국의 식단에 전목도 힘이 다 들어간다고 얘기하는 말이 있습니다. 전목을 대신 다 들어간다. 무슨 일을 하다 신이 들면은 아유 전목을 대신 다 들어가냐 하고 얘기합니다.
So there is a quotation in Korea. If you try to do something is so hard, then they will say, Hey, all my strength when I suck the baby's mama's milk is all gone.
예, 엄마 저절 빨아먹는데 얼마나 힘이 들었으면 일을 할때 힘들면 엄마 전복을 대신 다 들어간다는 얘기를 하겠습니다.
So what does it mean? That means they use this their all kinds of strength and the you know potential to suck it all the mother's milk is all so hard. So whenever any difficult thing is happening, oh this is just
just like when I was this baby, they suck this mother's milk. Is that much effort I have to do this?
그러니까 사랑이 없는 영양소의 소주설 먹이는보다는 사랑이 듬뿍 담긴 엄마 소주설 먹이는 것이 근명이라고 생각합니다.
So real meaning of the health is to feed the mother's milk with lots of love. Then the mother, I mean cow's milk with no love inside.
그냥 소에 바치는 엄마 되려거든 소주설 먹이고
So if you want to be, raise your baby with a very good strength, healthy body, then you should use mother's milk rather than cow's milk.
알았습니까?
Understand? Okay.
그래서 이 종자가 지금 현재 말이죠. 지금 나와 있는 종자들은 거의 다 화학물질에 의해서 만들어진 종자입니다.
So most of the seed are produced by this chemical manipulation, the product.
그래서 생명력이 적습니다.
So the strength of the livelihood is very weak.
그래서 이 종자를 심을 때 생명력을 두어두는 치료를 합니다.
So we have a special treatment for that weakened strength to the make it strong seed.
그래서 그 치료하는 영양제는 전부 집에서 만드는 겁니다.
So you make all this solution to make the strong seed to sprout and grow well at home.
그걸 알으시려면 좋은 교수님 영양을 가보십시오.
So if you want to learn that, then you go to see the John Cavery's farm.
갈 때 비전으로 가지 말고 무언적 선물을 가져가십시오.
So when you visit him, bring some gift for him.
오늘도 간단 좋은 개구리 저 의금이 야자 열매 따가지고서 물을 주더라고요.
We went to visit his farm. He picked this nice coconut, and then coconut juice he served us.
근데 저도 돈을 주지 안 받을 것 같아서 그냥 나오다 보니까 두통이가 가렸더라고.
So I felt I needed to pay some money, but if I pay the money, then she probably refused to take it. So when I come out, I had a little itchiness in the back of my head.
그래서 여러분들이 가실 때 선물을 가져가시면 그 코코넛 주스 한 잔을 먹어도 마음이 후련할 거라고.
So if you pay, then my the duty to pay him. Then you pay for them, for him. When you go to visit, bring some gift for him, okay? Then you can have a nice coconut juice.
그래서 지금 말씀드린 거는 여러분들이 그 종자가 생명력이 약하다고 알고 생명력을 들어오기 위해서 방식입니다.
So, I'm trying to say that when you seed nowadays, the seed itself is so weak, just like a human baby raised by this the cow's milk. So we try to make it weaken the seed to make it strong, because that's a special solution we recommend to use that.
그리고 여러분께서 공사 지시다가 만약에 의문이 난다 그러면 CGNF 하와이에다 연락을 해가지고 이 좋은 개보리한테 연락을 주십시오.
No,
Drake.
So if you have any questions or problems when you're farming, you ask this Drake. So the Drake can convey the questions to the Master Cho.
그러면 나한테 연락이 오면 내가 바로 연락 대답을 해서
So I'll try to answer your questions Drake.
여기 이것은 뭐냐면 과수원이라는 게 풀이 나가지고 아주 그 풀이 없애는 애를 많이 먹습니다.
So a lot of time we have a problem with weeds, right? In this is the orchard, but because of so much weeds on the ground.
근데 풀이 나는 걸 제주도로 줄게 아니라 여기다 풀을 자라지 못하면 풀을 뽑는 겁니다.
So rather than you spray this herbicide to kill all the weeds, you substitute with the stronger weeds, stronger crops that compete with this unwanted weeds.
지금 하와이에서 힘센 뭐라고 생각합니까?
What is the strongest weeds in Hawaii?
Ginger.
Huh?
Ginger.
Ginger?
Nut grass.
Huh?
Nut grass.
Nut grass. Cane grass.
Cane grass.
아니야. 그동안 그 관리자라고 신생은 없었냐.
The strongest crop you can compete with any weeds is a corn.
그 옥수수만큼 빨다는 힘이 있거든요.
So no weeds or no plants grow fastest or strongest than corn.
그래서 그것을 심어가지고 이제 키가 한 60m 씩 자랐다.
So you plant the corn seeds that grows about 60-70 centimeter high, about 2 feet.
그리고 수로 키우는 겁니다.
And then you cut and lay over, lay down.
그걸 수로 키우면 두께가 있지 않습니까?
So if you lay down, then there is a depth, I mean, the height of that the cover of the ground, yeah?
그러면 숨이 못 납니다.
Then no other weeds will grow.
그리고 잘 보양성 있는 미생물은 옥수수를 먹고 번식이 왕성해집니다.
The microorganism under the layover corn will be really thriving very actively.
그러니까 풀 잡고 미생물의 영양소를 쏟고.
So there's a double benefit. One is that you control the weeds. And the other one is you give a very excellent nutrients because the layover the corn is the food for the microorganism.
그래서 건강을 지키는 것은 이루는 농부도 건강해져야 되고 자라는 작물도 건강해져야 건강이 이루어지는 겁니다.
So health is not just for the human labor or human farmer. But also microorganism who is working down for you, it should be the healthy, strong food.
그래서 그 종류를 종자 종류 준비해놨더니 힘이 세게가지고 아주 잘자라는 겁니다.
So you, the seedling treatment, we already had this one in the seminar. If you treat with this one, in other words, soak the seeds before you plant them on the ground. Then they're very strong, they grow very well.
그래서 오늘 어떤 분이 제안을 해서 그 하와이와 전 미국을 아우르고 한태평의 지대를 아우르는 교육 장소를 만드는 후보들이라고 보고 왔습니다.
I visited one the farm, one lady's land today. She kind of proposed that we should make one learning center or training center of the natural farming in the state of Hawaii, and she offered that her land to be used for that purpose.
그래서 산골 교육기관을 만들어가지고 누구든지 언제든지 오면은 전화할 수 있도록.
So this could be the land of a training center or learning center of natural farming. So they can come anywhere in the whole United States or even foreign the farmers who want to come in to learn, then they could come from the center. I wanted to have a CGNF Hawaii control that learning center.
그렇게 해서 이게 이제 그 생물을 심는데 풀을 심는 것도 이게 하와이도 난공이냐 공이 아니냐 풀을 심는 거예요.
So also this one you have a cover crop as a corn as a cover crop.
그걸 비워서 이제 까는 거예요.
So you cut and then lay down.
그리고 여기 다 덮였잖아요.
So you cover up the whole area.
그럼 풀이 못 나는 거예요.
Then no more weeds. No. And then the soil becomes very fertile.
Mm-hmm. 양대 중앙으로 지을 것이 못돼 사람이나 겹치고 겹치고 치고 안 나고 미생물이 번지러 올 때는 아주 좋은 게 나와.
So if you have a letters that when you cover with this the weed cover, then they don't have any problem with the weed problem.
그러면 땅만큼 어딘 달고도 이제 붙더라는 거예요.
So very sponge type of the ground or soil.
그게 지혜가 되고 이렇게.
So not earthworm and the fertilizer from the earthworm too.
엄마의 건강한 젖이나 마찬가지.
This is same as a healthy mama's milk.
이게 이제 그 종자 치료하는 건데 이건 다음에 여러분들 시간을 가지고 올 수 있는 제가 좀 자세하게
Next time we're going to teach this one again. 이거 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 And then show you what you can do, very unusual way of making your health very strong. So, what do you think the, in the whole globe, what are the sources of the heat coming from? The sun, sun heat. Underground heat, right? We have a fire underground. We have a geothermal energy, right? That's the underground heat.
그 두 가지 자랑한데 하나 여기 거의 있습니다.
There's one more heat sources.
그건 뭐냐면 미생물이 발효할 때 일어나는 발효열입니다.
There's a heat coming from and the process of fermentation by the microorganism.
이게 풍스버리는장의 사진입니다.
So this is the picture we took it today in the John Kibler's farm.
이것이
어떤 미생물
성분을 만드는 겁니다.
This is the IMO number 3 that he
was making. 이걸 만드는 데 온도와 얼마가 올라가면
60도 When you make this one, temperature can go up to 65 to 70 degrees Fahrenheit centigrade.
그런데 우리 몸에 암이라든지 피부병, 피부암 이런 것들은 40도 온도는 죽습니다.
But if you know how about your cancer cell in your body, cancer cell in our body can be killed at temperature of 40 to 45 degrees centigrade. So we can generate to 70 degrees by this fermentation fever.
자연적으로 우리는 특정 인증으로 만든 건데 그 열을 갖다가 발현해가지고 여기 들어가서
So, if you have a cancer, then you can go into the fermentation heat area. You just put it in and soak to yourself or sauna. of this IMO bed. And then some of the cancer cell can be easily